Hi, friends.
Strangers.
Internet. My name is Emily Hanhan. I love colorful makeup and colorful language. And today, I'm here to do a try to get ready with me, putting together this makeup look, along with discussing a topic or a couple of topics that are near and dear to me. We're going to be talking about gatekeeping when it comes to the LGBTQIA community and gatekeeping when it comes to relationship advice, and just all of the ways that people like to tell us you haven't experienced a certain thing, so you are not allowed to comment on it, or you are not allowed to claim a certain label. I have used a bunch of makeup today, some of which was gifted to me from Shop Miss A, some of which I purchased with my own money. I will try to have everything listed in the description box, and there will be some affiliate links for some of the products if you choose to use them. It's so appreciated. There are other affiliate links and codes down there as well if you feel like supporting me in other ways. More than anything though, when it comes to this topic, when it comes to any topics related to sexuality and gender, to keep it respectful in the comments, you know, you can disagree with me, but there is no, none of the bullshit. None of it. You'll get blocked. You'll get hid. You'll get deleted. We don't put up with that around here. Because I know this was a rambly get ready with me, I'm going to try to keep this intro short and just remind you that if you like colorful makeup, if you like lots of opinions and cute fat babes in general, you should go and subscribe. Check out my Patreon and YouTube membership and any of my other social media goodies down in the description box. And otherwise, just keep on watching to see how this look came together and hear my thoughts on the bullshit that is gatekeeping. So today I wanted to talk about gatekeeping and the way that a lot of people tell, especially folks that are on the queer spectrum or in the alphabet mafia or however you want to define it, they tell us that we're not allowed to speak on a subject or that we don't know good enough because, mostly because we haven't experienced it ourselves. So I have always been single my entire life, and something that really bothered me, I would say especially even into college, was this idea that I didn't really have a valid take on someone else's relationship because I wasn't in a romantic or sexual relationship myself. When I was younger, I just kind of followed along with that perspective. I thought, you know, it's true. I'm looking at it as an outsider. I haven't experienced the situation. I haven't experienced relationships. And also the whole perspective of like, relationships take work. And a lot of times as friends, you know, we come to each other to talk through the hard times. Yeah, I used to feel that way. I used to kind of nod and smile along and think, yeah, okay, that's valid. Like, I'm only seeing it as an outsider. And, you know, there's always the take of like, well, they're your friends, so, you know, you are going to always come to their side when it comes to them talking about relationship issues. And that's damn right. If you're my friend and you are telling me about something that your partner, boyfriend, girlfriend, significant other, you know, did to you or is doing to you, yeah, I'm going to want to defend you. I am going to defend you. Like, that's what friends, in my opinion, that's what friends do. And while there's always multiple versions of the truth, which is what everyone always uses to excuse, like, just knowing the truth that your friend told you, I feel like is often used to excuse, like, not jumping in and making these harsh judgments and things like that. about other people, especially when it's relationship talk. It's always like, no, you know, you don't know the whole story. You only know from one perspective and blah, blah, blah. And it's like, okay, but that doesn't mean that I can't have feelings about the situation. But it just felt like so often this thought that, you know, if you are not experiencing romantic relationships or sexual relationships, that, you know, that experience, that lack of experience gives you no right to talk about it. And I'm so exhausted by that thought. I have realized, now I am asexual. If you are new around here, I'm asexual and aromantic, generally speaking. So for me, relationships, romantic relationships, sexual relationships, they're just not a part of my life. I have been that way basically my whole life, and I've only just found the words for it in the last couple of years. So for the longest time, you know, I would be the friend that would give support, and I would be there gently giving advice, gently, just very, very gently. Like, I would always kind of, I felt like I had to hold my tongue. I felt like I often had to, you know, be, here's the thing that, that sometimes is good for me and sometimes bites me in the ass as an adult. I can see both sides of an argument, and I can, you know, support both sides depending on my brain. That's not always great. Being able to see why an asshole is doing something and why it's not completely asshole-ish because, like, well, they have reasons. No, that's not it. That's not it for me. Growing up, and even until probably the last couple of years of my life, I always felt like I just had to be gentle with my advice to friends. I had to be gentle with, you know, my perspective on their partner. And I am exhausted by it. And I am completely over this notion that you have to do something to be, like, able to give advice. Now, I'm not saying this is true for everything. I'm not saying that everyone should go out and start giving advice about everything, even if you've never done it. But the thing, when it comes to relationships, is that we all understand respect and self-respect, and a lot of us might not be great at valuing ourselves, but we understand the concept of self-worth. So how is it that I, as somebody who has not been in a romantic relationship, am not allowed to give advice or feel concern when I see a friend, somebody who I know quite well, who I've spent years getting to know, who I have seen their insecurities, who I have had them share, you know, things about themselves that they struggle with, things that they are not good at doing when it comes to relationships. When I have seen all of this, how is that when I see them in a relationship where I see their partner finding their weak spots, finding their insecurities, and commenting on them, and making those insecurities a bigger, you know, point of contention, how is it that I am not valid in saying to my friend, this doesn't feel healthy? How is it that I can work on myself and, you know, take a look at what I am willing and not willing to give and take in friendships and all kinds of platonic relationships that I'm in, and, you know, negotiate boundaries and do all of these things. But when my friend is going through the same situation, I can't say anything because I've never fucked somebody I've set boundaries with. I mean, it seems like I've set boundaries by not fucking them, but somehow that invalidates all of the other boundary work that I've set. And to say that, you know, well, you don't know the work that's going into the relationship, or like a lot of the things that I would hear is like, well, you know, you are negating the good stuff. I am a friend or a family member, or I am somebody with a relationship to this person. They are not just telling me the bad stuff. I have seen the good stuff. I am, you know, evaluating that when I say something, when I decide that this feels really unpleasant for me as an outsider. Don't sit there and tell me that I'm only being defensive of my friend and I'm only seeing the bad stuff. I'm their friend. I listen and I care about them. So I've heard the good and the bad. Now, in a lot of moments, does the bad feel like the majority of the issue and it overtakes the good? Yes. But that's also not a bad thing. That's me as a friend saying, hey, so I know that you see all of this good and you only see a little bad, but I'm over here and I see these 10 bad things and I only see 5 good things. And to me, that does not seem like a equal balance. That does not seem like a valid exchange, a valued exchange. And I just think that people, heteronormativity and like relationship culture is so strong. I'm gonna especially say in the United States, in the Western world, that I feel like if you are the kind of person that has said, no, I'm stepping outside of that expectation, I'm stepping outside of those, you know, societal norms, that everything about yourself is negated almost instantly. Being asexual, being aromantic, being somebody that is queer, being somebody that just doesn't fall into the everyday norms. People that are doing that have thought a lot about it. So for you, you general, to sit there and tell me that I don't understand relationships, so I am not allowed to give advice, is absolutely wrong, because my life is full of relationships. And I know I've talked about this multiple times, but my platonic relationships are like a thing that keep my life going. They are rich and intimate and they are emotionally mature beyond what I see so many people go through in their romantic relationships. So I just think that the concept that you're not allowed to give advice when it comes to personal relationships, if you haven't done that before, is just fucking wrong. If you have other relationships in your life that other people would look at and say, yeah, that seems like a healthy relationship. Hell, other people don't even have to say that. But if you have friends, if you have people that you care deeply about, you have the emotional maturity and the depth and the range to get it. Also, we all understand what self-worth and self-respect is. And so if I see somebody in a relationship where they are not getting respected, where their worth is not being valued, where they are just being neglected, I fucking see that. And I am going to say something. Because too many people get stuck depending on other people in relationships for advice, And guess what? A lot of those other people in relationships are in fucking toxic relationships. So they are not going to see emotional abuse, manipulation, disrespect. And I see these things, and it's not every relationship that's worth ending. But as your friend, it makes me say, hey, I see this thing. And if you're asking me for advice about the relationship, then I'm going to comment on it. And so it's okay to say, you don't want to come to me for advice because I'm too harsh or I don't get it or whatever. But if you choose to come to me for advice, I'm not going to hold back just because I haven't dated a cis man or because I haven't dated anyone. But cis men in particular, no holds barred. So after spending so many years of my life kind of living in this space where, you know, I get treated like my advice is not valid or not valuable because, like, what do I know? When the reality is that I work long and hard to understand myself, respect myself, set boundaries, and do all these things that, I mean, I see given as relationship advice all the time. Once I realized, like, how fucked that perspective was, I started getting to know, like, more of my queer side, too. Which, I mean, I knew I was queer from a very young age, but didn't really, you know everything. I mean, I still don't know everything. What the fuck am I saying? But this topic got me thinking about the other kind of, like, gatekeeping that we do. And this is especially for people that might be on the asexual spectrum, but I think just in general, people that are, like, have been less sexually, you know, adventurous for whatever reason, whether it's their own issues with, like, body dysmorphia, because that can fuck you up and make sex really not worth having, or whether it's a conservative, you know, childhood into maybe adulthood, depending on if you are still living with family or around family, or all of these, there's so many different reasons why people may well know that they are bisexual or pansexual or demisexual or asexual or lesbian or gay or straight, and they have never had a sexual experience, they've never had a romantic interaction, they've never had any of it. Not everyone wants to or is able to have a, you know, phone book style run through of every single sexual escapade that is possible to figure out their sexuality. Telling an asexual person that they don't know they're asexual unless they at least have sex once is traumatizing. It's actively traumatizing to tell people that they don't know themselves better than you do. Or better than somebody else does. Telling people that they are not a certain label that they have decided to use because they have not gone through a litany of sexual experiences is inflicting trauma upon people. Because, I mean, there's so many layers to it. I know in my community of friends and acquaintances that are queer or just any label. I mean, really fucking any label. But I'm going to say in my community, people are real fucking reflective and self-aware. They have done a ton of work. And to get to a point where they can say, you know, I'm this. They have gone through so much work. And you, whether you are their friend, their brother, their coworker, a fucking stranger on the internet, you telling them, no, you actually don't know yourself because you haven't experienced XYZ, so you can't be that. You know, you haven't been with a man, so how could you be gay? You haven't had sex, so how could you be ace? These people, we have all been working on ourselves for decades, for some of us. You walking into the space and saying, yeah, you think you know who you are, but you don't, is disrespectful as fuck. It's not just disrespectful, it's wrong. You are wrong when you tell somebody you haven't experienced a certain level of your sexuality that you're claiming, so you don't get to claim it. You are just plain wrong. Getting to that point in your life where you have found a label, any label that feels right, and you feel safe and comfortable enough to come out and to talk about it and to vocally proclaim something that is just still dangerous in this world. And then for somebody to come into your life and say, oh, you can't be pansexual. You haven't been with multiple genders. People do a lot of self-work to get to that point. And for you, I don't care who you are in their life, to say that that's not true, that can't be true, you are just fucking wrong. And if you don't understand how that can just completely poison the well, how saying something like that to somebody who has worked to build themselves up brick by brick, who has figured out things about themselves that maybe they have pushed down or turned away from or denied in the past. You just sitting there being like, no, that can't be the case. If you don't get how damaging your falseness is, how damaging your fucking attitude and your gatekeeping bullshit is, if you can't get that, you really should just keep your mouth shut. You telling somebody that they are wrong about their label, they can't be right about their label until they do certain things, until they fit your stereotype of what that label is, I'm gonna say it's fucking homophobic. By making people have to fit into these stereotypes, jump this high, go through this hoop, all you're doing is perpetuating all of the bullshit that straight people do, that conservative people do, that homophobic people do. If you think that you have to do certain things to be able to claim a label, then just say it with your chest so that we know who to avoid, who to stay far away from. You're not a better person because you invalidate somebody else. You're not stronger or bigger because you have decided that they are not actually who they say they are. So let people use the labels that feel right for them, or not use any labels at all. Also, labels are not monoliths. So, if you're over there being like, but this person calling themselves bisexual makes me a bisexual upset because they haven't experienced anything, you're still wrong, and you can still shut the fuck up. The LGBTQIA population as a whole is not a monolith, and each label is not a monolith. So, if you are upset because someone is using a label in a way that makes you somebody else that also uses the label unhappy, well, you should just get used to it. Or go find yourself a different label if you feel like it's so easy to just pick and choose. But for those that have worked and put in whatever amount of effort it took to get to a point to pick a label, or again, to stay unlabeled, my camera is very rude and the battery pack ran out right as I was saying. If you don't agree with it, you can just keep your mouth shut. Okay, I feel like I have gone on and on and on and roundabout. And I think that generally I've made whatever points I can. Let someone use the labels they want to use or have chosen to use, no matter what you know of their life experiences. It does not invalidate them. Also, this is probably a whole other topic, a whole other get ready with me, but somebody changing their labels does also not invalidate their past. You can change your labels or go to unlabeled at any point in time. You are the only person that knows yourself. Here's the thing. For many of us, our knowledge grows. We are getting to know ourselves, our sexuality, our gender. At the same time, for a lot of us, we're also getting to know other labels, other people's sexualities, other people's genders. But yeah, changing your labels is real. It doesn't change who you are. It doesn't invalidate your journey. It doesn't invalidate your past or your future. And anyone that's watching that doesn't understand that, you don't have to understand. That's the other part of it. You don't have to understand someone's labels. You don't have to understand when they change them. You just have to respect them. And on that note, I think we're gonna call this a finished look. If you have any questions about any of the makeup I used, I will try to have it all listed in the description box, but feel free to leave a comment if you need any clarity. Otherwise, let me know. Let me know your respectful thoughts in the comments about any of these things that I've talked about today. And if you disagree with me, we can talk about it. Just don't be homophobic. It's a good life rule in general. Like the video if you liked it, share it out if you feel so inclined, and subscribe if you haven't already. But most importantly, don't forget to take care of yourself better today than you did yesterday, because you are worth it. Bye, friends.